We wish to acknowledge that we are on land that, at the time of contact, was held by the Attawandran as an area of trade and ceremony by the two rivers. At various times, the land was occupied by both the Haudenosaunee from the south and the Anishinaabe from the north. In more recent times, the Huron Treaty gave rights to the Mississaugas of New Credit. In a spirit of reconciliation, we seek to respect the history, the spirituality, and the culture of Indigenous peoples and seek a new relationship with the original people of this land, one based in honor and deep respect. May we who dwell on or visit these lands and waterways also be good stewards and honor those who came before us. And may our actions be guided by our commitment to reconciliation.
Of your peace. Set our hearts on the desire to be people of forgiveness. Open wide the doors of our hearts, that as we have been forgiven, so we may also forgive. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "But I say to you that listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you, and if anyone takes away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. If you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to receive as much again. But love your enemies, do good and lend, expecting nothing in return. Your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High, for he is kind to the ungrateful and the wicked. Be merciful, just as your Father is merciful. Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. Give, and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For the measure you give will be the measure you get back. The Gospel of Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Gracious God, open our hearts to the wonder of your forgiveness and mercy, and help us to be instruments of peace. Amen. Today's Gospel is perhaps one of the most challenging of all, and it begins with Jesus saying in St. Luke, "You have heard that it was said." And Jesus is really, in this opening part of the Gospel, setting himself up as the standard for all human action, all human loving, all human forgiving. And they're startling words as we read them. Jesus begins by saying, "Love your enemies, pray for those who persecute you." And maybe, given our experience where we live, maybe we feel very blessed. Maybe we can't call to mind someone whom we would honestly say is our enemy. But we realize that Jesus is speaking not only to us, but to every human being in our world. And when we hear the news, when we see it before us, especially through social media, we realize that there are a lot of people who would take these words in a different way. People who feel that they have enemies either about them, or plotting against them, or struggling. And we think Jesus has the message. And for us it means maybe taking a deeper look into those that maybe we're not drawn to, that maybe those that we struggle with. And he goes on and repeats again later in the same passage, as if maybe perhaps we have wax in our ears. He says again, "Love your enemies." And then he goes on to say, and it's the reminder, "Do not judge so you won't be judged. Forgive so that you can be forgiven." And I think it's a reminder, especially whenever we pray the Lord's Prayer, and I think this is where maybe St. Luke is leading us this Sunday, is to think about those beautiful words of Jesus. When we pray together, even if we're on our own, we pray it as members of a community of faith. "Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us." I think at the heart of the Gospel this Sunday is the reminder. We ask, and probably because we're so mindful of how merciful God is, we expect God to forgive us and show us mercy. But then how do we conduct our lives? It is not easy to find that place of deepest peace where we can forgive. And so maybe enemies don't come to mind, thank God for that. But maybe there are still those on whom we're on the outs with, or we struggle with, and we haven't really come to that place of letting go and forgiving. To ask God to forgive us necessitates that we're trying to find that place of forgiveness in our lives, and we ask God's help. Lord, I praise and thank you. You forgive me over and over again. Help me to come to that place of forgiveness in my own heart and to offer it to others. Striving to be people of forgiveness, mindful of God's forgiving love, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, so loving, so merciful, so forgiving, help us to come to that place of forgiveness in our lives, and bring peace to our troubled world. We ask this in all good things through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.